compared to yesterday. We had the blue skies, very pleasant conditions yesterday. Almost looks like winter outside right now with a bit of mist and drizzle for spots. Not feeling like winter, though, in the upper 70s to about 80 degrees and a high dew point as we have high humidity right now ahead of our week midweek cool front. Temperatures in the 70s, I think we'll top out near 80 this afternoon. Most spots have fine visibility, but I have noticed just a little bit of lowered visibility in a couple of spots, including Belle Chasse and farther along the coast. And here are all of these clouds. Notice that on radar, only a little bit of very small showers are showing up on radar, but you might encounter a few stray sprinkles here and there, even where it's not showing up in the green. Of course, we have the clouds with satellite imagery, and then out to the west is our cold front that we've been talking about. We have a big ridge of high pressure here, a huge trough of low pressure across the kind of half or so of the western U.S., a little more than that. And then, of course, here is Eta spinning in the southeast Gulf of Mexico. So a lot of things to kind of look at as we're centered pretty much in the middle of these. We have so much dry air with our water vapor imagery here, and these are the couple of things that are going to come into play to make Eta eventually weaken. Dry air, and also here is the big trough of low pressure with this southwesterly flow here. This is all going to scoot to the east as we get into the next few days. So the air with the shear should cause Eta to weaken. So we'll go into detail in just a second, but if you have plans for today, again, I have our high near about 80, 81. Clouds, sprinkles, maybe a few showers here and there, pretty light stuff, and humid conditions. And then tonight we'll be looking at lows only near 70 degrees, maybe a bit of patchy fog, and we'll continue with those clouds and a slight chance for showers. So moving from this afternoon, Tuesday, a couple of showers around at 1 p.m., 7 p.m., rain chance goes down maybe just a touch, and overnight, pretty quiet conditions. This is tomorrow as the cool front does approach and helps to spark maybe a few more showers. 2 p.m., 20% rain chance or so. And then here's the front moving through Wednesday night into Thursday. So Thursday and Friday are looking pretty nice. We'll get very slightly lower humidity as the front hangs near our coast. It's not going to go really far south, but I wanted to show you all the way to early Friday. We're looking pretty good in our part of the Gulf Coast. And this particular model has Eta way off over to the east. As you know, if you've been watching our forecast, the models are all over the place with Eta. But here's kind of what we're expecting. The weak front tomorrow, a stronger front this weekend. So yes, you can start getting excited if you want that fall feel back. And then maybe some rain this weekend, but so much depends on Eta. As I've been saying, I think the big thing is that it will be much weaker when it does enter the northern Gulf of Mexico. And right now, the National Hurricane Center's forecast has it very slowly getting into the north, kind of drawn to the north eventually, and then probably weakening a good bit, maybe even completely dissipating by the time it reaches the Gulf Coast. Looking at a couple of the models to give you an idea, the European model, compared to yesterday when it was going way off to the northeast, has a bit of rain for our area, but it takes a bit more of that northerly movement. Look at the new GFS model. It did have it coming close to Louisiana yesterday. Now it has almost no rain for Louisiana, and the system really weakening and moving to the northeast. So this is just crazy to look at this point, but notice that we are expecting it to move to the north, and as it weakens, there are a huge range of possibilities that could still happen. But in any case, even the Euro, which has some rain coming our way, has by Sunday night maybe a tenth or two-tenths of an inch of rain. The GFS has even less than that. So we are expecting maybe some showers, perhaps Saturday, maybe looking a bit more so Sunday. We will see, but we'll also have that cold front moving in this weekend, which might spark some of our rain as well. So big impacts from Eta, not looking like we're going to get those perhaps for Louisiana, but we still kind of have to wait and see. In any case, it would probably just be a sort of rainmaker if it did bring rain to the northern Gulf Coast. And again, as you saw, it might weaken completely with those factors. There is subtropical storm Theta way out almost to northern Africa, and eventually we'll keep moving off to the east near southern Europe. And then also we have another spot that we're watching. Not going to focus on this one too much for Louisiana's forecast because we are expecting it looks like right now, to move off to the west into Central America perhaps, but that could bring us to Iota if it does get a name. Incredible. Our 7-day forecast shows the lowered humidity Thursday and Friday. Slight rain chances at least this weekend. We'll keep you updated.